Hi, and welcome back to Type 1 Diabetes Explained. Today, we will go over how diabetes is treated by looking at the different types of insulin as well as injection methods. If you've been diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, then your doctors most likely prescribed you some type of insulin, and they also probably gave you more than one type. So you might be wondering, why do I need more than one type of insulin? Isn't insulin just insulin? Well, you're partially correct. If you don't have diabetes, then your pancreas is always producing insulin and pumping it into your body. Then, when you eat, your pancreas produces a large amount of insulin to cover the food that you just ate. But if you have diabetes, your pancreas isn't producing insulin as well as it should be, so you have to give your body extra. This is where the two different types of insulin come in. Chances are that your doctors prescribed you a long-acting insulin and a short-acting insulin. Let's look at each of these. The long-acting insulin is active for a long period of time, sometimes over 24 hours. This means that the insulin is present in your bloodstream for a long period of time. The long-acting insulin simulates the pancreas giving out small amounts of insulin all the time. You'll most likely give your long-acting insulin once daily. The short-acting insulin is active for a much shorter period of time. The short-acting insulin is used when you're about to eat to cover for the extra glucose. The short-acting insulin is most active around the 3-hour mark, but can be present for up to 10 or 11 hours. You will take the short-acting insulin before you eat or if your blood sugars are high. This simulates the pancreas giving out large amounts of insulin to cover for the extra glucose after eating. Now that we know what the two main types of insulin are, let's look at the two different injection methods of insulin. You will most likely either give insulin through a syringe or an insulin pen. The syringe is pretty simple. You draw the insulin out of a separate container and then inject it through the needle on the end of the syringe. The pins are roughly the same size as a pencil. The main difference is that they hold insulin in a small glass tube at the end of the pin, and you twist a dial on the other end to determine the dose. Here are some safety tips when giving insulin injections either with a syringe or an insulin pen. Always use a new, sterile needle. Make sure that the packaging is present and undamaged. Using an unsterile needle or using the same needle for more than one injection can lead to the injection site getting infected from any bacteria that could have collected on the needle. Also, never share needles with anybody else. This is one of the easiest ways to spread blood-borne diseases, and is just common sense not to share. Another very important thing to remember is to vary your injection sites. If you inject your insulin in the same spot over and over again, scar tissue will begin to build up, and the insulin will not be able to absorb into your body correctly, and your blood sugars will rise. Acceptable locations for insulin injection include the stomach, thighs, and the back of the arms. Consult your doctor to determine what areas are best for you to inject your insulin, or about any other areas that might be useful. The injections may be painful, so here are a few ways to reduce the amount of pain while giving insulin. Use the shortest needle possible. The shorter the needle, the less it goes into the body. Talk with your doctor about what size needle will be best, not only for injecting insulin properly, but also causing the least pain. You can also try numbing the area with a piece of ice or a cold spoon shortly before injecting, or ask your doctor about topical anesthetics that will have a similar effect. As always, make sure that the techniques you are using are what is best for you. Not every technique works for everybody. Your doctor will always know what will best manage your diabetes.